2,000 meters beneath the surface. That's just 20% of the ocean's total depth. We can go way deeper. And what we find along the way, it's nothing short of unbelievable. At 2,000 meters, or 2 kilometers, you'd expect total darkness. No sunlight reaches here, and yet you start seeing tiny lights glowing in the black. That's because we've just entered the bioluminescent zone, where almost 90% of sea life glows in the dark, just to survive. One of the creatures here, a small, terrifying thing known as the Absol dragonfish, but its teeth, 5 times sharper than a piranha's. Now let's drop down to 3,800 meters. This place is legendary, because it holds wreck of the Titanic. Yes, the real one. Lying silent and brokenly 4,000 meters deep. Keep going, we reach 5,000 meters, and officially enter the abyss zone. If you thought we were deep before, this is just the average depth of the world's oceans. Life is barely hanging on. You'll only find strange sea cucumbers. Giant glowing jellyfish the size of humans, and long-legged abyss crabs. Let's go even further, down to 6,000 meters, into the hydal zone. This place is hell underwater. The water temperature, never above 4 degrees Celsius. And the pressure, over 1,100 times greater than on land. To help you picture that, it's like carrying 335 full-grown African elephants on your shoulders. Yeah, that heavy. But now let's flip the view. From the deepest point on Earth to the highest, Mount Everest, standing tall at 8,848 meters. The tallest thing we've got. And yet, Everest could fit inside some off trenches in the ocean and still wouldn't reach the bottom, because in 2012, director James Cameron took a solo dive down to 10,898 meters. He stayed there for 3 hours. He described it as a lunar desert. No life, no movement. Just the sound of his sub creaking under pressure. And get this, back in 1960, two men went even deeper. They reached 10,960 meters. That's nearly 11 kilometers straight down. To put that in perspective, that's the same altitude commercial planes fly at. But instead of soaring through clouds, they were sinking into black silence. So, next time you jump into the ocean, just remember, you're swimming above a world almost no one has seen.